I have a book manuscript. I have no idea what to do with it. I've never done this before. What sorts of things should I be thinking about when I want to publish a book in philosophy of science?
I want people to be able to read that book, get access to it. Prestige. It's a publisher that perhaps, you know, if I'm looking for a job or if I am at a university who wants to promote me, they're going to be impressed that I published in that place. I care about whether or not I'm going to get good referees. I care about what the final product is going to kind of look like, the price. What publishing open access gives you is anyone can download a PDF of your book. Anyone can read it.
We end up with an open access book series for the philosophy of science. Over the next 5 years, we're hoping to get five.
10 monographs in 5 years.
10 monographs.
10 monographs in 5 years, yeah.
Yeah, 10 monographs. These are open access, so these will be available online to anyone who wants to read them and available in print if people want to buy them.
These are folks who have been doing open access for a long time, and so they kind of know how to make open access work in the marketplace, as it were.
The quality of their product is extremely nice, but they are kind of beautifully formatted on the page. They're very easy to navigate and very nice looking. So, you know, you're not getting a sub-quality product by having it mostly available online.
The BSPS Open has a really prestigious editorial board. The editorial chair is Helen Beebe at the University of Manchester. And go to the BSPS Open website and check out the editorial board. You'll see it's some of the field's top philosophers of science.
We didn't get anyone like turning down the invitation to be a member of the editorial team, did we? Like everyone, we kind of put together our dream team and they all said yes, which shows you how excited everyone is to see this go ahead.
It is a remarkable project that we ended up with. And I think everybody, once they realized what we had here, wanted to be a part of it. How much do I have to pay with BSPS Open as an author?
Zero.
But in what currency? Okay, zero, zero.
Seriously.
How is that possible? I mean, it sounds a bit like a scam. Nobody has to pay anything. How does this work?
Where does the money come from, David?
Yeah, where does the money come from?
So here we should thank the generosity of our publisher. They have been cultivating open access for already a decade. They have lots of people with expertise in open access coming from the archive, the big physics archive, and one of the biggest open access communities in the world. They have committed to give us a try. 10 monographs that the BSPS Open should select for them, and they will publish them in print, and they will release the PDF for free. Depositing and indexing it in all the major repositories. This hasn't never been tried before in philosophy. We are gonna be able to give this a try and provide a model, a template, for other societies and publishers to do something similar. So I put my PDF for free out there. I mean, what happens? I mean, how do I make sure that this book is not used in a way that betrays my original intentions as an author?
Like I download it and start trying to sell it, you know, on eBay. How do you prevent people like me from exploiting your work?
That's what Creative Commons licenses are for, because these Creative Commons licenses are legal documents that establish the conditions under which your book can be reused. And here we're gonna use a Creative Commons license that prevents other people from commercializing your book or to modify it in ways you don't intend it to be modified. Creative Commons licenses in Calgary University Press's hands are a guarantee that your book is what you actually intended to be.
When you publish open access, there's more people reading it, hands down. There's tons of studies that show this. When you publish open access papers or monographs, you have way more people ultimately citing your work and more people reading it. And then, you know, there's nothing worse than when you publish a book to have it go out into the sea and get lost like a message in a bottle.
Right at the bottom of New Zealand, we were far away from everything and everyone. I don't think I could have done my PhD topic if I hadn't had access to, well, for me, it was all of the materials relating to Newton's work. Which became available online through the Newton Project while I was doing my PhD. I could not have done that research where I was in that location without open access material. We give people like me and, you know, students in all these universities where they don't have access to the conferences and the talks and things like that. They're not seeing all of that you know, new, diverse, cutting edge philosophy of science for themselves, but they can get access to the books. And so I think that's one of the reasons why it's really important that something like BSPSOPEN is producing cutting edge, diverse philosophy of science.
Are there any tips for the kind of manuscripts that you're looking for at the BSPSOPEN?
The sorts of things I'm really interested in seeing are books of philosophy of science that are really sort of pushing the envelope, ones that are asking new questions, ones that are using new techniques, new methods, new approaches, while also, of course, when it can be, being rooted in the kind of rigorous philosophical method that is kind of what makes philosophy work, partly in virtue of it being open and free. It seems like a brilliant venue for publishing things that are opening up the sorts of things that we can talk about within the philosophy of science.
We should say it's only for research monographs.
Yeah, there's a bunch of things not to submit, right? It's like you've got your collected volume from a conference. That doesn't work for the BSPSOPEN. You have your textbook that you're hoping to use for your intro philosophy of science course. That also doesn't work for BSPSOPEN. We're specifically looking for cutting edge research monographs in philosophy of science. Go to our website, Google BSPSOPEN, and you'll find a form that you have to fill out. And this includes some standard stuff like what sort of thing your book is about, what the competing literature is, what your timeline is, include a sample chapter, your CV, some things that you generally put with a book submission, and you drop it in an email to us.
Our model looks a little bit more like a paper publishing sort of way of going, where we have a collection of editors and associate editors with whom the buck stops. The process of publication, of course, from the author's perspective, is going to be very, very similar. It's going to be a very, very careful, rigorous process. That's going to come over to it being a prestigious publication in a context where anyone who meets those kinds of standards of book is able to have access to those, that open publishing access, without having to pay themselves.
Individuals have been making sure that their book can be open access, but what's valuable about this is that we can do it kind of as a collective action thing. If we can start making it so that philosophy of science books more generally are just open access, that is much better for the field, and it's going to be better for philosophy more generally.
So send your books.
Yeah, we look forward to seeing your submissions in the BSPSOPEN email inbox.